cave dwellers only. Just cave dwellers only. Now, if you've never been in a cave, then I'm not talking to you. But if you've been in a cave, then you will understand and appreciate this message. And I know some of y'all just hesitate, y'all slow because of the fact that y'all don't know where I'm going with this. But before I finish this message, I hope that I will have convinced everybody in here that at some point in time in your life, you've been in a cave. Come on, somebody. And I want you to think about how you reacted when you were in. What do we learn from being in a cave? I got a few things that I need to leave with you to let you know the next time that you're in a cave. I'm just talking to the cave dwellers. I'm just talking about those who have been down and out. I'm talking about those who felt like they've been so low. There ain't no way other than up. And I hear you with me. I'm talking to those who somebody, instead of trying to reach and pull you up, but they kept on pushing you down to the ground. And I'm so glad that I know my man named Jesus. Anybody know him? I'm talking about Mary, baby. And I'll bring it on to 2014. He's my Savior. He's my King of Kings. He's my Lord of Lords. He's my doctor in the sick room. He's my lawyer. Anybody ever had a courtroom? If you didn't know how you were going to get out, but Jesus stepped in. Right on time. I'm trying to close this thing. But let me tell you some lessons we can learn when we're in the cave of life. Number one, it will show you who's really on your side. But God bless, when you get in the cave, you'll know who your real friends are. A real friend, they will hold on, they will stick with you. Can I get a witness? I know about 8 years ago, can I get a witness? They told me down at Miller's Chapel, they didn't need me no more. And I want to tell you, I thank God for pastor like pastorship and some other brothers who came to me and told me it's gonna be all right. God is putting you in the cave so you can reload. Ever since that day, after I came out of the cave, dog, I went on and finished up my doctor's degree. But had I not gone in the cave, I may not have been able to come out and do what the Lord has told me to do. So don't mind. Can I get a witness? Let me tell y'all the next lesson that you can learn from being a cave of life. It might be an indicator that you have outgrown your previous level. Somebody ought to shout right now. Maybe the reason why you're in the cave, because God is getting ready to raise you to another level. And you're outgrown the current level. Can I get a witness? Let me tell you the third lesson that you need to learn. You need this morning at Church of New Beginning, I talked about where is Jesus when you need him. I told them there were two disciples that were on the road to Emmaus. Emmaus from Jerusalem was about a 7-mile journey. While they were complaining, they were asking questions, where is Jesus? But after a while, Jesus showed up. When he first showed up, they didn't recognize who Jesus was. Can you hear me? But after they kept on talking, and Jesus told them that you don't believe what the Word of God is saying, he had to come to be crucified. And after he talked through teaching them, the eyes opened up, and they realized that Jesus had disappeared. I want to tell y'all that Paul Rock, he didn't disappear. He just changed over. So when you're in the cave, Jesus did not leave you. He's still right by your side. Can I hear with me? I'm trying to stop this thing. Lesson number 4. While you were in the cave, you need to understand that you will never know how strong something is built until the storm is over. Can I hear with me? You'll never know how strong a tree is until the wind blows. It might be a strong oak, might be a pine, but it ain't got no wind to test the strength. You'll never know how rooted and how grounded it is. I'm out of here, all right. But I need to tell you, I serve a God. Oh, hallelujah. Every once in a while, I ask the Lord, just let me feel you. Just one more time. When I'm in my day, I ask the Lord, let me feel your presence. Just one more time. I'm going to receive you. I told the congregation this morning the story, but I want to share it with you. There was a college student told the grandmother, said, "Grandmama, I don't believe in God no more. I don't believe in Jesus no more." And she didn't say nothing. She just wondered for a minute, "Why don't you believe him?" But she didn't say nothing, because he said, "You know, if you can't see it, if you can't hear it, if you can't taste it, if you can't feel it, it's not real." So that day, she prepared his favorite dish. It was some candy yams, and he ate those candy yams. But late on in the night, that sugar in the candy yams got down in one of his cavities, and he began to have a toothache. He sat up in the bed. He said, "Oh, Grandmama, I got a toothache." And he said, "It's hurting so bad." And I heard the grandmama say, "Well, grandson, can you see the toothache?" He said, "No, Grandmama, I can't see the toothache." She said, "Well, can you hear it?" He said, "No, Grandmama, I can't hear it." She said, "Well, can you taste it?" He said, "No, I can't taste the toothache." She said, "Well, according to your philosophy, professor, if you can't see it, if you can't hear it, if you can't taste it, I'm this is where it's from. You know, yeah, it's funny how God works. When I first started out, and I was talking about for cave dwellers only, I didn't have a whole lot of folks that was a cave dweller. But right now, I think you got a few more folks.